In the last decade, China has experienced tremendous economic prosperity. However, parts of China have faced a major obstacle to continued growth, crossing rivers, particularly the wide, tempestuous Yangtze. The Taizhou three-pylon suspension bridge is a breakthrough in bridge construction and the world's first long-span, double-span suspension bridge. 2,940 meters, or 9,650 feet, long. The two spans are each 1,080 meters, or 3,540 feet, long. Completed in 2012, the bridge links the cities of Taizhou and Yangzhou, north of the Yangtze River, with Zhejiang and Changzhou, south of the river. The site was a challenge. The river is about 2.1 kilometers wide at the bridge. The riverbed has channels on each side. Both riverbanks have soft soil and a thick cover layer, with bedrock starting at 190 meters deep. Minimizing the environmental impact on the river was a key project goal. A conventional bridge system simply would not work. Conventional bridges require multiple bridge spans and foundations in the water. A conventional bridge would harm the river's ecological system and hinder ship traffic. After investigating all options, the project team decided on a suspension bridge with three pylons and two main spans. The central pylon is 200 meters high, with its feet 34.75 meters apart and its legs connected at a height of 69.5 meters. This design was the most environmentally friendly because it used fewer bridge piers in the water. It provided two navigation channels to accommodate ship traffic and encouraged the development of new port facilities. This innovative suspension system is a significant improvement over conventional two-pylon suspension systems. It provides an additional pylon and vertical support, which reduce the internal forces on the main cables and anchors. The design required the perfect balance of flexibility and rigidity in its 192-meter, or 630 feet tall, steel central pylon to withstand changing and imbalanced loads on each side. The complementary side pylons are 178 meters, or 584 feet tall, and are made of concrete. The two main cables supporting the bridge are 3,110 meters, or 10,200 feet long, and 72 centimeters, or 28 inches, in diameter. The design team investigated different pylon types. Only the inverted Y pylon resisted cable slip and held up against stresses and deflections. Never before had anyone designed and built such a long-span, three-pylon suspension bridge in a continuous suspension system. The bridge was planned, designed, and constructed by four key entities. Jiangsu Provincial Yangtze River Highway Bridge Construction Commanding Department, Jiangsu Provincial Communications Planning and Design Institute Company Limited, AECOM Asia Company Limited, the 2nd Navigational Engineering Bureau and the 2nd Highway Engineering Bureau of China Communications Construction Company. Key features of the bridge are: the bridge is the first long-span, continuous suspension bridge to be constructed with three pylons and two main spans. A 200-meter-high steel central pylon prevents cable slippage and pylon stiffness. The longest suspension cable required two 3,110-meter-long main cables and was a test of modern cable technology. The project included the first-ever concurrent erection of two long suspended deck girders in an integral suspension system, a tremendous engineering challenge. Taizhou Bridge has received prestigious awards, most recently the 2014 Outstanding Structure Award from the International Association for Bridge and Structural Engineering. The Institution of Structural Engineers also honored the project with two awards in 2013. The Structural Award in the Highway or Railway Bridge Structures category, and the Supreme Award, the ultimate accolade for structural engineering excellence. The Taizhou Bridge is now part of a freeway connecting the cities of Taizhou, and Yangzhou in the north, and Zhenjiang and Changzhou in the south. This extraordinary example of design ingenuity is a catalyst for further economic growth in eastern China, providing a main transportation artery across the Yangtze River safely, efficiently, and in an environmentally responsible manner.